This video is sponsored by BuyCheapMuttCoins.com. Make sure you head on over there for all your Muttcoin purchases. Use code GS5 for a discount at checkout. What up, what up? What is going on, everybody? First and foremost, shout out to everybody who went to that Tyrese video yesterday and said, GS then brought me. Shout out to you guys. You guys are biblical beasts. So today, we have yet another online ranked match. Now, I know I forgot the the gauntlet. There we go. Took me a while. I know I forgot the gauntlet yesterday. You know, we're supposed to do gauntlets every Friday going in alphabetical order. That's not a word. Alphabetical, but we're going to use it. In alphabetical order. But, yeah, I forgot. I'm not going to lie. I forgot. So, we're going to do that today. Today at 9 o'clock. You guys can't be expecting that beautiful gauntlet video of me somehow getting robbed by EA when clearly I beat it like 12 times. But they cheat me out of it. So today we have the Jets going up against the Detroit Lions in this beautiful online ranked match. So 2nd and 18, he tries to go deep up top to Calvin Johnson, and we drop late interception. Now he was just coming out and like Hail Mary, as you see, like kind of little confusing, you know, just coming out and like Hail Mary trips and just tossing it up there. And his offense is, you know, quite unorthodox. Right here with Matthew Stafford, he rolls out, throws across his body, and throws an absolute dot. And kind of juked me out of my shoes, but thankfully we end up wrapping them up anyways. So 3rd and 5 again, he decides to roll out, and then we cause an incompletion. 4th and 5 right here, he goes over the middle, and he gets the first down. Good job by him hitting me with them 4 verticals. So 2nd down and 10 right here, he's taking the part, and again, cross his body, quick little underneath pass. I'm thinking to myself, all right, okay, we're going to stop you sooner or later. Maybe I won't. My defense sucks. Maybe I won't. Right here, hits me a nice little screen play, runs forward, and he gets, is that the first down? Close to it. 2nd and inches, then he goes towards the outside, and we stop him there. Actually, lost half an inches. That right there hits me in the elbow. 4th and goal, he decides to go for it, and he does pick up the first down on the 1-yard line. We stop him right there, and then the next play, again, it's another run. This time, he trucks his way into the end zone. So we're down 7-0. Not looking good. I didn't like our defensive performance right there. Not at all. Not whatsoever. I wasn't satisfied. None. Zip. Zero. Zilch. Nada. My bacon count. All that is zero. Nothing. So right here, we got CJ2K. And of course, we got Calvin. Not Calvin. We're going up against Calvin. Whenever you have Chris Johnson, you know, you got that speed, man. You want to be able to just hit a nice little breakaway seam and take off. That's what I'm hoping for. So right here, Michael Vick gets hit before we could attempt to throw the ball. Right here again, just really quick pass towards the outside. 3rd and 4 right here. Open. He's open. If he makes that throw accurately, it's a first down. But no, Michael Vick decides to be Michael Vick, and he overthrows him badly. Right here, really quick fake bubble screen, and that ends up leaving Calvin Johnson wide open. So we got a lot of things to adjust, and right here is just wow. Did I spell that right? Hopefully I did. Hopefully I did. We're down 14-0 right here, and I'm playing Michael Vick. We should be on offense right now. We should. But no, he wants to overthrow folks. And then he breaks the tackle to the backfield, and then, I mean, come on. Come on, man. Right here, really quick underneath throw right there. You know, we got underneath throws too, baby. Right here, we go to Chris Ivory. And again, I don't know what's up with my OBS, man. I like recording with OBS because the files are compressed. You know, a 1 full game with OBS is probably going to take, I don't know, 5 gigabytes. With Elgato, it's going to be like a 17-gigabyte file. And that is Ebola trying to transfer over to your editor and trying to, it takes forever. But I know I keep saying it, but I'm probably legit going to have to just stop with the OBS and just use, because I can't. This little skipping thing, it's OBS related. And I probably got like 4 batch of videos left. And then after that, I promise it's not going to happen no more. I apologize. I don't know why I keep doing this. Nonetheless, 3rd and 11 right here. We could really use this first down. Step up in the pocket, and we don't get anything. So 4th down, swaggetry, man. We got to go for the field goal, and it's not looking good. 2 possessions on offense. He scored both times, and pretty easily. So I'm definitely thinking he's probably going to score here. A stop would be huge, but I'm not banking on it. Right here, again, he decides to roll out. Plenty of running room, but doesn't pass the ball. He doesn't run, but he goes underneath right there. And thankfully, we get a warp tackle that pretty much stopped him. So 2nd and 5 right here. Again, he decides to roll out, and looking for a receiver. You know how rolling out does, man. It definitely attracts a lot of defenders towards you, which leaves defenders open, and receivers over there. Right here, he kind of tosses it up one-on-one, and thankfully, he doesn't come through with the catch. Second and 10 right here, a little over a minute remaining. And again, he just goes underneath and picks up a catch. But it's that fumble. That hit stick, dude. We might have killed him. I don't know. Our offense went straight to the field. I didn't check his post or nothing. I'm disrespectful like that. Right here, nice little run. Woohoo! 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 Chris Johnson right there with the beautiful game. Then we go back to Chris Johnson. And, oh, man, I should have spun a little earlier. So here we go, second and 12 right here. Step up in the pocket. And we go. Nice outside shoulder throw to Decker. And we end up getting to about the three-yard line. We QB sneak. We don't get the first down. Right there, we don't get it. Well, not the first down, but the touchdown, to say. Right here, we decide to just hand the ball up. And we actually score. So that right there was big. You know, we were able to turn a fumble into a touchdown. And that was huge because, you know, who knows if we would have been able to score. I possibly could have been down 21-3. So that right there was big. Not to mention, we do receive ball at halftime. So we actually have the ability to go on ahead and take the lead here. Really quick screenplay to Chris Johnson. You definitely might see me throwing a little bit more screens here than usual because Chris Johnson has a lot of speed and I want to give him the ball a lot because he's really fast. We get sacked right there. Third and 17. It's not likely we're going to pick this up, but we try and we get picked off and our opportunity to take the lead is just over. And now I'm thinking to myself, damn, damn, damn. Oh, man. Second and 10 right here. He decides to run the ball towards the outside. We get ourselves a decent stop at 3 yards. He decides to go back to the run, and we stop him. Fourth down right here because not everybody has fourth down swaggery. Plenty of time I get stuck on a defense lineman, which I hate. I'm praying that the coverage is looking good. He decides to run. Then he stops, and we just get to him before he can throw the ball and force an incomplete pass. So that right there was a huge stop, you know, being able to go on ahead and get that fourth down stop because we all know – I don't stop too many people on fourth down. He may be the only one. That might be my first Madden 15 fourth down stop. I don't know. I can't recall. I'm legally blind. That's my story, and I'm sticking to it. You can't tell me nothing. So nice throw over there to Harvin, and he holds on to the pass right there. 3rd and 2, and Michael Vick. I wanted to break something. I wanted to break something badly. Badly right there. But, you know, Michael Vick just being Michael Vick, I guess. I don't know. I can't call it. I don't know. Oh, man. So we're still down in the game. Again, he goes to the fake screen underneath. You know, I'll give that up, you know. Right here, he goes. Nice throw over the seams right there. Picks up a huge gain. And it's like, okay, man, we got to make some adjustments. He's just freaking throwing. And every time he throws the ball, somebody's wide open. 2nd and 10, we finally get a sack, causing a 3rd and 16 right here. He rolls out again. And he decides to go over towards the left side. Well, thankfully, it was dropped. 4th and 16, he's like, you know, YOLO, I'm going for it. And we're going to send the pressure. He breaks a sack. Of course, right? And he just tosses up. Thankfully, he didn't have anybody open because I would have been irate if somehow, some way, he found somebody open after that broken sack. I would have been irate. He did a very good job of staying towards the inside. Anytime it was a one-on-one situation, he manually locked on and crashed towards the inside. So every time I spun or juked, it was right into a hit stick. I give him that. His usering on one-on-one tackles was immaculate. I should have adjusted and started juking more towards the outside, but I did not. Right here, we try to run for it. We break a tackle with Vic. We break another tackle with Vic, and we get stopped shy of the first down. So 3rd and 2, I decide to run the ball YOLO. Yeah, we get the outside, and we finally end up taking the lead and try to go for 2 right here to see if we can go on ahead and get ourselves a full 7-point lead. Unfortunately, that did not work out. So here we go. We are up 5, and I'm definitely a little nervous, you know, because his offense has been proven to move down the field at will at times. So definitely a little nervous. So, but one thing that did happen, I'm not sure when, what was right there, beautiful interception by Landry. Give it a minute. What happened at some point was that Matthew Stafford got injured during a sack, and he was gone for the remainder of the game. And that right there was huge. Definitely a huge boost of momentum. Right here, you know, we'll take a field goal. You know, it sucks because that'll only put us up 8, but we will take a field goal. You see, set 3rd and 2, just playing for a field goal, but we actually end up picking up the first down. Right here, we end up running with Chris Johnson again. Possibly could have scored, but I felt like the spin move was better. He's wasting all of his timeouts. Right here, we go through the screen plan. 3rd and goal, and woo, that double juke, no. And we end up scoring. Again, trying to go for 2 to make up that last 2-point conversion that we lost. So 27-14 right now, and he has no timeouts, none. Obviously, he was banking on trying to hold me to a field goal, which thankfully did not happen. So that right there was a huge touchdown, putting us up, again, 2 possessions and making it tough for him to try and come back because, again, he has no timeouts. He's going to need a touchdown, and he's also going to need a onside kick. No way he can win without it. So, again, you know, on defense right here. We send a blitz and we end up getting to him in time. At this point, all we really got to do is just waste some time right here. Again, he has no timeouts. So we're just going to run a few plays right here and end up just milking the clock. So that's the end of the video, guys. Hopefully you guys enjoyed. Tough one, but we hung in there and we ended up coming up with the victory. Love each and every single one of you guys, man. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the video. If you guys made it this far in the video, don't be disrespectful, man. Go ahead and hit that like button. Hopefully you guys enjoyed. Your boy GS, we're going to be out. Peace.